Hi there, Steve Walker here from Ahoy Boats, where I teach people who are interested in taking up rowing about boats and the sort of things that you need to understand about boats and about rowing. And I hope that I enthuse people with my enthusiasm for rowing. I've been rowing for over 40 years now, and sculling and coaching, coxing, racing. In fact, I'm racing tomorrow on the river that's flowing past my window here. I'm active in every way in rowing, and I hope that I can bring to you some of the joy of rowing and explain to you what the essence of rowing is. It never ceases to amaze me that I can, well, I've been rowing for 40 years and 30 years of them on the same river, going up and down the same bit of river, and yet I never get bored with it. So let me see if I can get to the bottom of that and explain to you why it is that I don't get bored with rowing. Is it the communing with nature? The fact that I'm seeing unusual things on the river, birds, dragonflies, kingfishers, herons, dab chicks, salmon jumping out of the water, seal. I saw a seal. I've seen a few seals on this river. And we're way at river. We're 25 miles from the sea here. And in fact, I remember stopping a crew I was coaching once and saying, "Stop, stop, look, there's a salmon and it's got a fish in its mouth." Not a salmon, a seal, and it's got a fish in its mouth. You know, this is a very unusual thing to see, but I've seen it a couple of times. Deer on the riverside, cormorants, little grebes, big grebes. There's always something going on. But to be honest, you could see all these things if you went fishing or if you went walking your dog alongside the river. There is another aspect, that's to say that seeing the scenery on the side of the river from a boat. You get to see the river bank from the river instead of looking at the river from the river bank. That's interesting, seeing things from a different perspective. But that's not really what keeps me going and what gets me out there doing it every day. Why did I row in horrible rough water on Monday and then do 14k on calm water on Tuesday and then another 10k yesterday, and I'm going to be racing tomorrow over that same course? And what makes me do that? Is it the feeling of well-being that I get from the whole body exercise that rowing is? The extra flexibility, the buzz, the endorphins flowing around my body, the body's natural painkillers. Is it that? Well, you know, partly. That is a benefit of rowing. I've never really been fat. I'm lucky in that way. I've always been interested in keeping fit and staying fit. I've been variously a runner and a gymnast and a swimmer and now a rower. And yet I have seen people who've come into the sport who were fat, or people who've been previously fit and have stopped rowing and have become fat. And then when they start rowing, they lose weight and get down to a fit weight. So this is one of the benefits of rowing. And the reason for that is that rowing uses so many muscles. And muscles are like the engine in the body, and fat is like the fuel tank. And if you build up the engine and get the engine to consume more fuel, then there's less fat available around the body, and it's not that you turn fat into muscle, it's that the muscle grows and the fat is no longer there because you've consumed it. You consume it in order to feed the engine. Having said that, I've seen people who've been thin, painfully thin, and have taken up rowing and have grown to become the shape that is necessary for rowing. And then when they stop rowing again, instead of reverting to being fat, they revert to being thin. So basically everybody has their body type that they would be if they didn't do anything, but if they row, they end up in a rowing shape, the shape that's ideal for rowing, or as near as their body can get them to that. There's another benefit of rowing, and that is something that you can't really see when you look at somebody, and that is the effect on the heart. The heart has, it's a muscle, it's a pump, and it's like any other muscle, it can be trained by exercise. But there are two types of adaptation that the heart makes. One is that it grows in and pumps more volume of blood, a greater volume of blood per stroke. And the sort of training that induces that effect is endurance training. So marathon runners will have big hearts with a high stroke volume. So when they are resting, their pulse rate is naturally low because they get so much blood pumped for each stroke of the heart that they don't need to do many strokes per minute. Cyclists fall into this category as well. Endurance cyclists, they very often have low heart rates when they're resting. Sprinters and weightlifters, on the other hand, their hearts change in a different way. When the body is making a massive effort and all the muscles are recruited in order to stabilize and lift a huge weight, then all this tension in the muscles squeezes all the capillaries that's supposed to have blood flow through them. They get squeezed, so the blood has difficulty getting through. And this means that there's a terrific back pressure that the heart has to overcome in order to try and force the blood through these shut capillaries. And then when the muscles relax, then the blood gushes through. And you'll see all the veins on the heads of these people standing up because the blood goes to the head because it can't go anywhere else. But in order to withstand that pressure, the heart has to be stronger in order to pump blood into these capillaries that have all been closed off. And so the heart wall becomes thicker in this case. And the thing about rowing is that you have both of these effects. It's an endurance sport. We row for great distances. Typical rowing outing would be for about an hour and a half. And yet we are making strong contractions with all the muscles in our body in order to propel the boat in the power phase of the stroke, and then we relax on the recovery part of the stroke, and that's when the blood is able to flow into all our capillaries. And if you don't do this, your forearms tie up and you can't square and feather your blades and so on. I don't know if you've ever rowed in a gym on a rowing machine, but it's pretty difficult to motivate yourself to keep going for more than 20 minutes. And an hour and a half would be mind-bogglingly boring. It's much easier to keep yourself going in a boat. And that's one of the reasons why you consume so much energy and lose weight. So, rowers end up with a heart that is not only big with high stroke volume, but also strong with thick walls. So it's a great benefit to your heart, and the reduction not in the risk of heart attack, but in the survivability of a heart attack. In fact, I row regularly with a heart attack victim. And he has, since having his heart attack, won Henley medals with me in veteran races in the same crew. And he's won national medals. So if you have a strong heart, you can still carry on rowing. There is a benefit there to be drawn from rowing. But is that what gets me out there? No, it isn't what gets me out there. I do enjoy all those benefits. I like to be lean and fit and strong and everything. And I have to be, because I'm only small, I'm only 5'8". So I have to have good technique as well in order to be competitive against bigger people. But that's not really what it is that makes me go out there all the time. Those are sort of side benefits, if you like. What about crew rowing? I just mentioned rowing in a crew. A joy shared is a joy doubled, no question. If you have struggled to achieve something with a group of people, and then you get there, and you, well, even if you don't get there, even if you row together better than you dared hope and produce the performance of your life, then that is a joy doubled. Doing it on your own, you take all the credit. You take all the blame as well, of course, if you fail. But no question, if you have a crew, then that is a very enjoyable thing. And it doesn't really explain why it is enjoyable to go out in a single. I mean, I love crew rowing and crew sculling, particularly crew sculling. But it doesn't explain why what sort of buzz I get from going out in a single. Although I have to say, I do prefer to go out sculling in my single with another person or a group of people. So there again, a joy shared. So in fact, one of the things that has entered the language is this idea of being in the same boat together as other people. You know, we say we're all in the same boat, don't we? It's one of those things that you say. And if you've ever been in a boat with somebody, you remember that you've rowed with them. And quite often, memorable things that happen will crop up in conversation later in later years. So, what else? Well, rowing is not a natural thing to do. It's not something like running. It's not even like swimming. I suppose cycling isn't particularly natural. But rowing certainly isn't something that your body is expected to do. And so you have to learn it. It's a new skill. And there's nothing quite like learning a new skill. It's exciting. In fact, one of the most, successful and enthusiastic recruiters to my club are the novices, the people who've only just taken it up because they so love this whole journey that they're on, learning to row, learning to make a boat move, all the different things that you have to pick up, because there's a whole vocabulary of stuff you have to learn, which end of the boat is which side is which, what end of an oar is what. There's a lot to learn about rowing, and this makes it exciting. In fact, I'm still learning. The challenge of rowing a perfect stroke is so great that it's virtually impossible to row 10 perfect strokes one after another, especially at a competitive pace. So all the time that I'm out there in a single, I'm struggling to try and do it perfectly, and it is a constant battle. So that is one of the things that motivates me to do the challenge of rowing better and performing better in certain conditions, very windy conditions or a crosswind or difficult stream or whatever. All of these things are make it interesting. But still, that isn't really what it is that I really love about rowing. So, what is it? It's the glide. You know, when you're skating and you push off one leg and you glide on the other leg, and then you push off that leg and then you glide on the other leg, that's fun. And it's like when you're cycling, if you're cycling up a hill, that's hard work, but then you get the reward of cycling down the hill where you don't have to do anything, you get motion for nothing. And you get that stroke after stroke after stroke with rowing. You take a stroke, and then the boat glides. And in between the strokes, it's what we call run. And you can either make the run of the boat work for you, or you can destroy the run, check the boat. And this is your reward for a stroke well taken, the run of the boat. And that is one of the most pleasant things, when you can get a crew to work so well together that the boat is floating effortlessly underneath you in the recovery part of the stroke. This is one of the most enjoyable parts of rowing. So, there are lots of different benefits of rowing, getting out in nature and seeing wildlife and so on. It's a whole body exercise, bonding with other people in crews, learning the skill, which you're always doing, it's never over, and then this reward that you get. Every stroke you take, then you get a reward from that stroke. Or you don't quite get it, so you're challenged to try and do it better the next stroke. This is what rowing is all about for me. And I hope that helps you and enthuses you and encourages you to become a rower and to take the sport up. I love it. I've been doing it for 40 years and I hope to do it for another 40 years. So if you like this video, please click on the like button below and look out for the next video that I'm producing. And in the meantime, stay safe on the water, eat healthily, and enjoy rowing.